Hello everybody, welcome to MNB World Talk Show. Today we are really proud to announce our guest because she is a representative of the Moon Dance Band, the band that brought Mongolia to one of the top six dance groups in the world. So please welcome, she is Mrs. Lausrin Tsindayush. So thank you very much for accepting our invitation.
Okay, thank you for having me.
Of course, Moon Dance really become popular because it represents Mongolia like a Who band, yeah? So could you please tell us about Moon Dance itself, about the story of this group, and when exactly did you join that group?
Okay, my dancing story is related to my kindergarten memories. So I would like to share my kindergarten, how I began to start the dance.
Of course.
Okay, and my kindergarten teacher actually taught me how to dance and how to listen music. Mm-hmm. And also she gave me a big chance to dance on the stage in front of the many people. Mm-hmm. And this was my first feeling of dancing. Mm-hmm. And after my kindergarten, sixth or seventh grade, I think so, and I heard the Mongolian Child Palace, and there was a dance class. So I went to the Mongolian Child Palace and learned Mongolian traditional dance, folk dance, and ballet, hip hop dance, modern dance, and of course dance sport. Mm-hmm. And I was more interested in dance sport. Mm-hmm. So I want to have more specialized training of dance sport. Mm-hmm. And so I decided to change my dance class and choose a dance sport club, which name is Line of Dance. Mm. And I was dancing in Line of Dance for 6 years. And during this time, I participated Mongolian Championship, People's Sport Cup, and Capital Cities Championship also. And most successful and highly ranked competition was People's Sport Cup, because the sport cup involves all kind of sports, and also it's organized once in 4 years.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, and I took third place. Also, I took second place in Mongolian Championship, Capital Cities Championship also, and our team was established in 2013, and I heard the name of this band in 2013 also, but in that year I gave birth and also graduated from my university, and I had no chance to dance.
That's amazing, right?
Yeah, and next year also I got a job, and still my baby girl was too small, and also I had no chance to dance also. And in 2015 things changed. One of them is my daughter turned 2 years old. It means I could leave her alone. Actually no, not alone, with her daddy or grandparents. And I contacted my teachers. We met in 2010, and I expressed my vision and inspiration, and I wanted to attend World Championship.
Back,
yes, I want to dance again. And they accepted my wish and also welcomed me very politely. I was so appreciated.
Okay. And could you please tell us about your group itself? Like, how many members do you have about Moon Dance group itself?
Totally 40 members in the band. But some of us are retired. Some of us are still dancing. Some of us got full-time job. But only 16 people compete and dance on the floor. It means eight couple, one lady, one man dance together. Eight couple dance on the floor.
Okay. So thank you very much. Now let us introduce you to our audience in photos and resume. Let's take a look. Thank you. But let me ask you, who directs exactly your all those performances?
We don't have director, mm-hmm. and our team has officially two teachers, okay. and our teachers made choreography. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and our teachers are husband and wife, oh, one family.
Family,
yes,
okay.
yes, and okay. And during this time, we attended World Championship for 6 times. Mm. Yes, mm-hmm. and also we participated international dance competition, which was held in England. World Championships gave us opportunities, such as we traveled to the European countries. Mm-hmm. We traveled to Austria, mm-hmm. Germany. Wow. France, Spain, Switzerland.
Whole Europe. Almost.
Well, yeah, almost. yeah. And this is the how we got relaxed after the competition and so many stressful days.
Of course, right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I think now it's time to ask you, like, I know that you did your master's in business administration, right?
Yeah.
And how that happened that you became a dancer, like, I mean, professionally, right? You are not engaged now with business administration, right? To business administration. And so how that happened?
Oh, I think women have to be highly educated. This is life guarantee, I mm-hmm. think. Yeah, you say that I'm related to the dance. My business administration is not related to the dance, mm-hmm. yeah. But I really love dancing. Mm. Yeah, I was dancing since 13 years old already. Mm-hmm. Yeah, dance is my whole life.
Your passion.
Yeah, yes. I cannot imagine my life without dance.
So that's why you're dedicating
yes,
yourself to
yes,
the dancer.
Yes, of course.
Okay. So, and what about the feelings? What feelings do you get from dancing?
Okay, when I dance, I feel everybody's movement, and also I can reduce my stress. Uh-huh. Yes, and also one of them is I'm being in good shape. Also,
Sure.
And also it gives me high feeling of aesthetics. Uh-huh. Yeah.
So you said that you are getting really nice feelings from dance art, right? But you said also that you avoid stress by this, right?
Yes.
But I think that this is kind of work, right? And of course you're becoming sometimes really overloaded, right?
Yes,
but
of course.
Is it stress in the same way or it's really not a stress? How do you define this?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of stress is that? Or
Especially training time was a very bad time, mm-hmm. I think, because we are so overloaded, mm-hmm. and we don't have time to spend with my family. Mm-hmm. And we train every evening, mm-hmm. because most of us are student, mm-hmm. and have full-time job, mm-hmm. so we have to train during the evening time, mm-hmm. and we don't have time to spend with family, uh-huh. During the training time. Yes, it was so stressful. Mm-hmm. But like I said before, we got relaxed in European countries after competition.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. So now, then let's see your dance classes. How do you work on okay. the stage?
Yes, of course. Thank you.
my work. Our club full name is Mondays Club, and I usually teach in adult and junior classes. And this is junior classes, and this is very important class for us because in this class, our next generations are prepared, and I and my teacher are teaching in this class. Okay, these cups are identifying our sexes, and first three cups are given from Mongolian championships, and next three are from the world championship. And last time we took this cup from the world championship, which was held in Germany in 2019. Last time we took this cup, and it's very hard to describe the feeling of when we took it, because there were so many incredible dancers and bands from the all around the world. And our performance name is Falco. Why we named the performance as a falcon is the bird is Mongolian proud falcon, and a proud bird, and so we named it.
Wow, cool. So then let's talk about your family. Could you please introduce members of your family?
Okay, I live with my husband and my daughter. Okay, my husband works at a personal company, and my daughter is 7 years old, and now she's second grade. And yeah, and my husband is big support and big fan of me. Yeah, he always supports me well. Wow. And he always goes to the world championship with me also.
So he admires
yes,
you.
Yes, we created a very good memory together.
So what about your daughter?
Oh, she doesn't like dance. It's so weird. But she always goes with me to the training and always watches me and said, "Oh, mommy, you are amazing dancer." Always says like those words. And she is more interested in painting.
Oh.
Yes, and she said me
art too.
Yes, yes, and also she said me that she's going to dance soon.
Oh,
yes.
<wow. laughs> So you have a continuation.
Yes, I think so. I hope.
Okay. What kind of mom are you?
Okay, during my training, I was not good mom actually. Yeah. But I'm trying to be a good mom for my daughter. And I think my husband says how I am a good mom. I can't answer it, sorry.
So you are a hard worker, but you have also a hobby, as I know, right? You are a translator.
Yeah.
So maybe let's take a look at that package that shows your hobby.
Okay, in my free time, I usually do translation, and I work at translation center, which based in Stockholm, Sweden, and I have to work at least 10 hours in a week. And I usually translate documents and paper and sometimes contracts. For today, they have sent me two documents, and it will take not much time, and maybe 1 hour, 1 hour and a half. Okay, and my second work is I'm studying. Soon I'm going to take international exam, which name is Project Management Professional. I have to study 2 hours every morning.
Okay, so and finally, what is your biggest goal and dream?
Okay, my goal and dreams are same. I really want to become a world champion, and whole team's purpose is also same. Mm-hmm. Everyone want to become a world champion also.
Of course.
Yes, right. Yes, and the dream come true in 4 to 5 years, I think.
Wow.
Yes.
So when exactly the next championship?
Oh, next championship will be held in end of this year. Uh-huh. Yes, it will be held in Germany.
Right.
Yes, we will travel to Europe big game.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Well, thank you very much. And I really wish you to be a champion, a world champion. And thank you very much for your coming.
Thank you so much. Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you. So this has been Mrs. Klaus Rinsendeusch, who is a representative of the Moondance Band. Thank you very much, and we will see you next Wednesday at the same time. Have a nice evening. Goodbye.